In this video, we'll consider the basic nature of light, and you'll see why a singular explanation fails to capture its full essence. Light. We depend on it every day, and yet it has been a bit of an enigma throughout history. What actually is it? Is it matter? A wave? A particle? First, a bit of history. Throughout the 1700s, the model of light that reigned supreme came from Isaac Newton. It's called the corpuscular theory, and it suggests that light is made up of small discrete particles called corpuscles that travel in a straight line. But at the beginning of the 1800s, people started to see holes in this corpuscular theory. An English physician and physicist showed us that light is not so simple. Thomas Young wanted to know what happens when light from two sources overlaps. How does light diffract? Light was shined towards two slits in a screen. When the light was split into two separate beams and then recombined, it gave a peculiar interference pattern. If light were indeed a particle, you would expect the interference pattern to mirror the slits in shape and size. But in reality, the light was spread out. The light from the two sources overlapped and interfered with one another, creating some bright fringes and some dark fringes, behaving in a similar way to ripples or waves on a pond of water. This is something particles cannot do. The pattern could only be explained if we consider light as a wave. Light, it has since been concluded, has a dual nature. Its wave nature and the particle nature. Let's first consider light's wave nature. All waves share some basic characteristics. A wave is a disturbance that propagates through space. In terms of composition, the wave nature of light describes it as an electromagnetic field, made up of a magnetic field perpendicular to an electric field. Look at the shape of the wave. The distance between two successive crests or troughs is called the wavelength. The number of wavelengths within a specified time period is the frequency. And the height of each wave compared to its mean position is called the amplitude. The speed of light is 3×10⁸ meters per second, as long as the light is traveling within a vacuum. That means that light could travel around the Earth a whopping 7.5 times in a second. Now let's turn to the particle nature of light. Light behaves like a stream of particles. We call these particles photons, and each has an energy, E. The amount of energy depends on the frequency of light. Energy, E, in joules, is equal to the frequency in hertz multiplied by Planck's constant, which has the value 6.63×10⁻³⁴ joule seconds. E equals HF. Don't be fooled into thinking light is simply a particle or simply a wave. Neither model can fully capture its true nature. So, say a photon in a light wave has a frequency of 4×10⁴ hertz. How much energy does that photon hold? To find the answer, simply plug the frequency along with Planck's constant into the formula, E equals HF. The photon has an energy of 2.7×10⁻⁹ joules. Hopefully, you now understand more about the radiant and mysterious phenomenon that is light. For more Chegg physics videos like this one, hit subscribe.